Hello and welcome back to a new video of About Koi. In this video we are going to talk about Shusui. Shusui are very eye-catching koi fish, as you probably have already spotted. And what I will do in this video is introduce briefly what this variety is all about. And I will also discuss with you like on what aspects should you select a Shusui on. What we will also do at the end of this video is discuss which of these five is the best one in my opinion and why is that the case. These Shusui are from last year, about 9 or 10 months old I think by now. So that is quite young, but I think it is good enough to discuss this variety with you. So first of all, a little bit of background. And it is that the Shusui is actually an Asagi. Now, as you can spot, it does have the same colors. So the bottom of the Shusui is just like the Asagi, also orange. And on the top, on the back of the Shusui, you can spot the darker scales, which have a really nice pattern on the Shusui. So it looks a little bit like the zipper pattern. So the big scales on the back of the koi. On the Asagi, that is of course different, because the Asagi is a scaled variety. So that means the, it's just like a normal fish, it has normal scales. But you only have the few big scales on the back. And on an Asagi, all the scales on the back are actually dark. While on Shusui, as you can see, it's only the small row that are visible in the middle of their back, the zipper. What you would like to have on a Shusui is that the dark scales on the back are nicely placed and symmetrical. You want them to be in one big line. And the orange should also be as symmetric as possible. And that really can make them really nice. So you can see quite some differences in these five koi. But that are really the main things for Shusui. So let's zoom in a little bit more on these five Shusui, and I will tell you which of the five I like most, and I'm also going to ask you like which of the five is your favorite. The Shusui variety is a non-metallic koi, so it doesn't have shininess in it, and most preferable is that the scales on the back are nicely and properly placed, as symmetric as possible in a nice row, and it shouldn't have any missing scales or open places, because that really makes the Shusui look less beautiful. What you also don't want is that the orange comes up to the middle of the back of the koi. You want it to be just above the lateral line, that's the preferred place, and you still want a nice white strip visible in between the orange and the nice bluish dark scales on the back. And then the more symmetric the Shusui is, the nicer and the better it is. So let's zoom in and discuss what we think about these five Shusui. What I will try to do with you is discuss them one by one. So let's start with the one just in front of me. This one, what you can see, if you look at the zipper scales on the back, you can see it is almost a perfect row. You can also see that it is quite symmetric. So you can see on both sides of the dorsal fin, you see a really small row of really small scales. That's really good. You can also spot that the orange is nicely, really symmetric on this one. So that's quite good. Both of the gills are orange. There's still a white strip visible of orange between the dark scales and the orange just above the lateral line, so that's nice. What I also like is that in both pectoral fins, actually the orange is also symmetric, so that's good. So it's really, really not a bad Shusui, so that's nice. I do like this one as well. Then let's follow on with the next one.
So what can we see here? We can see that this one also is really symmetrical. But what we also see is just before the dorsal fin, you can see that just two or four scales are missing. If it had that, then it would really be a nice row of scales. Furthermore, just above the gills, symmetric orange visible. The orange is on the sides. Between the dark scales and the orange, there is still some white visible, which is good. So also not a bad shisui. Follow them with this one. So what can we see here? Red nose, well, it's not so preferred because a shisui shouldn't have any red on the head actually, or any orange on the head. So of course it's still okay now because it's symmetrical. Then we don't really see the black scales on the back here. If you compare it with the other one just behind it, look at that. That one has nice dark blue scales. This one doesn't really have that. Not a big problem. Well, actually it is a problem. It's just not what you want the shisui to be. So if you ask me, this one is really a lot worse than the other one. So if you look at the middle section orange, just before the dorsal fin, so this area of orange, then it looks like that it is almost on the back of the koi, and there's a little bit of white missing in between the scales on the back and the orange. We prefer to have a little bit of white there. Okay, now for now on, move on to the next one. The first thing you immediately spot, and that is also why, for this reason, I think this one is surely not the best one out of the five. That is that, the scales. There's a gap of scales visible there. And of course, on a shisui, you don't want that gap to be there. So just here, there's a small gap. So the zipper is missing. Furthermore, the orange is quite symmetrical, I think. Not that bad. And then we have one last one. And then the last one. This one has a bit more orange. The head is more orange, which we don't really like on a shisui, actually. But what is even worse is that the zipper doesn't start just behind the head, but it starts on the head. So in between the eyes, you can see black. And that's what you don't want on a shisui, so that's not that good. So this one is also, the orange is already too intense. You don't want that. So you also see that on the back of the koi, there's a lot of orange. There's almost no white between the zipper scales and the orange section. So this one that I showed you as first one is a lot better. So what I did is I gave you a little bit of details on the differences in these five shisui. Now what I will do first is ask you which one is your favorite and why is that the case? And you can add it in the comments, and of course I will reply to that, and we can have a discussion together on these five shisui. What I will do now is I will, and you probably already know that I have two good ones that I like. That's this one and this one, these two actually that you see now, that are my two favorite ones. And the reasons for that are, I think, quite obvious. These two both have a nice row of scales visible on their back. So that's one of the reasons. And the other reason is that they're in between the zipper scales on the back and the orange, there's still some space left. So there's still some white left. And now the hard question is, of course, which one is better, the one jumping, so this one, Or is the other one? So which of the two? I think I will go for this one. And the reason for that is if you look at the zipper, then you can see that between the dark scales, there's white visible, or at least it's a wider color. Well, this one is really dark in between the scales. And usually what happens is that if you have that bluish grayish look there, then usually over the years it will become darker and darker and almost black. And that's what I really don't want. The scales are a little bit better, but it's too dark in between the scales for me. Also, if you look in between the eyes on the head area, it looks really dark. For that reason, this one is my first pick. Then I have my second pick. And then I think I will go with this one that is a little bit of scales missing as my third pick. The dark one as my fourth pick. And the really light one that is missing scales on its back is on the fifth place. So that is my order of these five Shishui. Of course, I also hope that you will share your opinion and also why in the comments. I'm looking forward to that, and I'm also looking forward that you subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I hope to see you back in the next video. So if you want to know anything about koi, then you have to follow About Koi. Simple as that. So I hope to see you again in my next video. Thanks for watching again, and see you later.